Hey guys, Nick here, and welcome to our Cornerstone introduction video. We're just going to be going over the brief details on this phone. We've got more in-depth videos coming up, so enjoy. Cornerstone has two aspects, the editor area and the preview area. The editor is where you make all your site's customizations, while the preview area just displays those customizations. Although being much larger, the preview area really doesn't do much other than help you select elements on the page and figure out how your elements are going to lay out. In one of Cornerstone's newest updates, they added Skeletal View, which allows you to view the page without any of the visuals. This is a really good way to get the framework of your site before you start customizing all of your elements. Okay, so we're going to start out with the editor. The very first tab in the editor is the Layout tab. This is where you basically customize the backbone of your site. In this tab, you'll handle the sections, rows, and columns. You can also manage templates here as well. As a new user to Cornerstone, I highly recommend inserting all of the theme code blocks and pages into your site and studying the elements and how they're customized to figure out how to use them. The most useful thing that I found when I was starting out with Cornerstone was that you can import any of theme code's provided demos and then open them up and study them inside of Cornerstone's editor and get an understanding of how they work. I mean, these all come free, so there's really no reason not to import them and study them. Don't forget that you can make templates out of anything in Cornerstone if you have it imported, so don't be afraid to, you know, pull some of your demo content into your own site and edit it to your liking. Honestly, if you're a new web designer and you're using Xtheme, you can build a completely professional looking site without knowing anything, really, just using the demo content and the theme code provided blocks. Alright, so the next section of the editor we're going to be covering is the Elements tab. This is a library of elements that come with Cornerstone. These are used just by clicking and dragging them onto the page. As you can see here, as you click and drag, the places where you can drop the elements are highlighted. Now, there are a few elements that you can't access through the elements library here, and the way that we get access to those is through using the text element. I'm just going to drop that on the page, and what you do is you click on this insert shortcodes icon right here. It's just a black box. Pull that up, and that'll give you access to all of the shortcodes, and you can just click on any one of them and edit it to what you want it to look like. And what that'll do is generate a shortcode for you once you click insert shortcode at the bottom of the page. So I'm just going to use the pull quote because that's an example of one that's not in the library. And I'm just going to say this is a pull quote. Perfect. Citing myself, of course. And what you do is you click on the little insert shortcode button down here. And boom, you've got the code generated, and you can just use that anywhere on your site if you don't want to have to use the Elements interface. This is really, really useful if you want to, you know, expand your website throughout without having to use Cornerstone all the time. We have a video series coming up where we go in depth on every single element individually, so keep an eye on our channel for that. Also on our site, visualicity.com, we plan on having a page for every element too, in case you're not the video type and you'd prefer to see it in article form. The third section is the inspector window. This is where you make all of your elements' individual adjustments. If you select an element on the page, it'll automatically highlight it inside the inspector window, as well as displaying the name of the element at the top. It'll also show you a breadcrumb navigation that allows you to easily switch between columns, rows, and sections. As I said before, this is the section where you're going to make all of your elements' individual customizations. Each element will have different options just based on what it is. The one thing that is congruent between all the elements is the ID, class, and style options down here. For now, I'm just going to move on over to the Settings tab. Despite being simply labeled Settings, this is actually a really useful tab right here. This is where you can add custom CSS to the page individually with the built-in code editor, which highlights all your code, makes things really, really simple. Also, you can add custom JavaScript here as well. I mean, this is awesome. And like I said, it only affects the page individually that you're working on. It won't affect any other page. You also have the ability to edit things that previously you could only edit in the WordPress dashboard, like the title. You can change it from being a draft or published. You can allow comments. Select the parent page, and even change a page template. This is a prime example of how ThemeCo is trying to save us time in our editing process. We found the next tab to be extremely useful. It's the X-specific settings tab. This is where you can change body classes. You can also add a custom index title to one of the WordPress index pages. And an example of a WordPress index page would be the blog page. So for instance, if you want to change your blog page to tutorials like we did, then this is where you would do that. You can also disable the page title for custom designs if you want more room to actually build your page and you don't need the page title there. You can also activate your one-page navigation here by choosing the one-page navigation menu you'd like to use. Down here, you're able to enter background image URLs. You can add multiple URLs by separating them with commas. You're also able to add image fade and image duration. And what this does is creates a slideshow for your images, just in case you want to create a non-static background. This can really add an extra visual layer to your site. The next tab is super useful, and that's responsive text. What this does is creates a selector that you can add to any text element on your website, and that will make that text element responsive to the device and the device's size that's viewing it. You're able to change the compression, which will change the rate at which your text compresses. You're able to change the minimum size that your text will shrink down to, and also the maximum size, just in case you don't want it going over or under a specific size, you know, just based on what your website looks like. And lastly, you have an option to easily navigate to the customizer. Okay, so it's time to move on to the bottom part of the editor. I'm going to start with the collapse button, and it does exactly what it says it does, and that's collapse the page so you can view it fully. The next button is the navigation button, or at least that's what I like to call it, and this gives you a quick navigation to the WordPress dashboard or the ability to view the page outside of Cornerstone, which can be useful. This is another part of ThemeCo's attempt to make everything quickly accessible inside of Cornerstone. The next option is this little eye icon, and if you enable that, it'll display a little text box explaining the various customization options inside of Cornerstone. This is super useful when you're starting out, and I recommend having this activated so you can figure out exactly what everything does. The next option, which is one of the newer integrations in Cornerstone, at least when this video is recorded, is Skeletal View. And one thing I forgot to mention earlier about Skeletal View is that in the bottom right-hand corner, there's a little preview window that will highlight the elements that you're hovering over in Skeletal View. This is really helpful for figuring out exactly what you're looking at on the page. The next button is the Device Viewer, which is this little phone button right here. And what this allows you to do is view what your website will look like on various common device sizes. This is super useful for customizing for the outputting device, and it's a great tool for any web developer. Finally, there's this last button, which is the save button. When you click that, you'll get some positive reinforcement, which is always nice. Alright guys, well thank you for watching. Be sure to subscribe and stay tuned for our next videos. We've got a lot of Cornerstone tutorials coming up, so be on the lookout for that. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you next time.